not having a space. So in our own local context, we have worked with MACBA, with Garage in the public space in lots of places, which means not only a one-to-one relationship among us and those spaces or projects, but also a relationship that is established among them. But other than that, for example, we were invited last year to the Gwangju Biennale, to something promoted by Bina Choi from Casco in Utrecht, which is also part of which is part of Cluster, and we were invited, like a tiny project, we can say, together with Cado Seme, for example, which is also part of Cluster, and it was, I think, more than 100 projects, like small to medium size projects. And I completely agree that it's like also the future, not only self-organization, but like communal organization in that sense. And then also to, regarding the other question, we actually do care about the public coming, like not only the quality, but also the quantity, but not regarding the what Reina Sofia could care about. I mean, the numbers that you have to justify because of funding, even if we do have public funding. But for us, it's important because we defend the work of the artists and curators we work with. We have a residency program and a training program in visual arts. So for us, it's important the openness, the type of people that comes, like not only art people from the arts, because it's usually the case with small projects like ours, and also how we are disseminating the knowledge we are producing together with those people. So that was the comment. And then the question is related to the previous conversation on market. And I mean, we started talking about art book fairs, but then also institution and market. And I haven't decided if I agree about this separation, market and institution, like meaning private and public, because depending on the context, it's not evil and God. Like in Mexico, for example, we were there last year, and talking about private and public money, they would laugh at us saying that we prefer public money, because which public money we're talking about. And so the question would be, like, what do you think about this new kind of thing, which is starting to be the more and more usual, of independent spaces or projects taking part in fairs, whether they are like only independent spaces fairs, or part of bigger fairs. I'm thinking about Pop Positions in Brussels, or even SWAB in Barcelona have had independent projects and spaces as a section of the fair. And I'm thinking about spaces like Lulu in Mexico, for example, which is an independent space, but also selling works. Or even in my context, Green Parrot has done it, Ejol has done it. So what do you think about this mixed model of an independent space, which can become partly commercial?
I can say that I already do. You talk about propositions. We were invited last week for propositions, and we said no, because I believe if we start doing art fairs, of course, you know, like each person chooses their direction. But I believe that very easily, if artists run space, start to, well, let's start the other way around. There's already too much art fairs, you know, for the galleries. So that should be why there's so much energy, so much money put into art fairs in first place. And then adding to that problem, what I think is a problem nowadays, the importance of art fairs, is that now it's, there's these artisan spaces playing the art galleries, because if you start selling, I don't know, very easily you will fall on the same logic as a commercial gallery. You know, it's very tricky. You know, you can deal with it, but yeah, it's we really don't want to be involved in commercial.
I have a little bit different opinion. I don't see these two worlds as opposite. I think we have to to observe and understand beyond that kind of very simple diversities. So, or oppositions, better. We are going to book fairs and art fairs last 10 years. We never meant to do this, but it's just happened. And also, there is one person in the gallery who is responsible for this part of job, and who is doing the whole preparation and organization and installation and so on. So this is his work. And we see also these art fairs, which we have to say, it's never too much of art fairs, because they are also dying. They are appearing, but they are dying. Because it's like in economy, it's a very strong competition also in this world. So we see these art fairs as a platform for presentation of local artists, and this is also one opportunity to get the really high numbers of viewers in 3 days, which is otherwise impossible. Through these art fairs, we got a lot of invitation for international exhibitions. So we see it also as one of the channels to get, for the artists, to get more international exchange. So it depends. Everyone can decide, of course.
Okay, if we don't have any question more, I think that is...
Thank you.
Okay, thank you very much. Thank you very much to you. This evening, we have an open an exhibition in Centro Centro, in Cibeles, about the alternative art scene in Madrid in the 90s. And this evening, we will do a guided visit to this exhibition with our guests, and it is open to you if you want to come. It's possible that we try to separate Spanish and English. This is this evening in Centro Centro, the fourth plant at 5, floor at 5. You are invited to this evening. And tomorrow, sorry, we follow. Tomorrow we follow here with the second table at Spanish, not more. Telephone translation with speakers from Madrid and from other parts from Spain. You are invited to come tomorrow. And anyway, again, thank you very much to our guests today for your talks. See you later.